Hello, and welcome to another ResTech tip. In today's tip, we will be covering GC inlet maintenance. So for many labs out there who are running complex samples with dirty matrices, you've probably experienced your chromatography getting worse over time. This comes in the form of loss of signal or response, peak tailing, or extra peaks due to analyte breakdown. Chances are, you probably need to do some inlet maintenance, which will help your chromatography bounce back. To do this, we'll replace the septum, inlet liner and O-ring, inlet seal, and possibly cut a section of column to remove any residue buildup on the front end. First, we'll cool our inlet and oven, as well as turn off the instrument flow. Once these have cooled, we'll uninstall the inlet end of our column and trim it if needed. After this, we'll replace the septum and remove the inlet liner and O-ring. Next, using the appropriate sized wrench, remove the inlet reducing nut so that the inlet seal can be replaced. Once the inlet seal has been replaced and the inlet reducing nut has been reconnected, place a new clean liner and O-ring into the inlet. Our chromatography should be back to normal or looking much better. To prevent unwanted instrument downtime before a major problem occurs, I like to put my instruments on a preventative maintenance schedule. Once you understand the sample matrix you are working with, plan ahead by setting a routine schedule for changing your inlet supplies. Keeping your inlet clean and happy will prevent frustration and give you more time for analyzing samples. If you enjoy these videos, please like and subscribe. You can also share your own ideas for a future tip in the comments below. Thanks again for watching this ResTech tip.